Hi everyone, so welcome to another lecture video on disinfection and sterilization. This is an important lecture. The sterilization part can come as a long question in your internal or external examination. From disinfection, there may be short questions, okay? But you need to know both. First, disinfection. Okay, this is a very short topic. We will discuss the agents in four heads. First of all, the agent, how they are used, and the properties of disinfectant, and aseptic properties, precautions. You see, this I have already told in my lecture videos about which is disinfectant, which is antiseptic. Both can be a same compound. When used in the living tissue, it is known as antiseptic. And when you are using in inanimate objects, it is known as disinfectant. The most common disinfectant is alcohol. Okay, isopropyl alcohol or ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol is now not being used much. The concentration of isopropyl alcohol is 50 to 70%. Okay, concentration of ethyl alcohol is 70%. These two compounds, alcohols, are used as spot cleaning. It means when the other two compounds are not available, so you can use alcohol as a disinfectant. Okay. Next, the disinfectant properties. Good, will rate. Most of the disinfectants are good. We are comparing the antiseptic properties. You see, the antiseptic properties of alcohol is very. That is why they are being used in sanitizers, which you are using in combating the COVID situation, because they have very good antiseptic properties. So they can kill bacteria and the viruses in your hand. Next, the precautions are, they are corrosive to stainless steel. So if you are the surgical instruments, which are basically stainless steels, you should not wash them with alcohol for prolonged time or over a period of time. Second precaution or second disadvantage you can say is volatility. The alcohols are very much of volatile. So if you are not keeping in a closed container, they will evaporate. Next one is chlorine compound. Mostly we use hypochlorite. Okay, sodium hypochlorite, which we basically use. Okay, sodium hypochlorite. It is mainly used for cleaning the clothes. Okay. And the disinfectant properties are very good. All of them are very good disinfectant. I am discussing only the compounds which are used in surgery or surgery department. Okay, I am not discussing the whole disinfectants. Okay, there are many disinfectants, but I am telling you only those which are used. Next, antiseptic properties are fair. Why fair? Because they are inactivated by organic debris. So tissue is organic, so they do not have very good antiseptic properties. And remember, the concentration used for antiseptic properties are 0.005%. You will find this concentration in some shampoos, which are basically used to combat pyoderma. Dogs and cats, and for pyoderma, you can use this shampoo containing sodium hypochlorite. They have fairly good results. Okay. Even people are suggesting using sodium hypochlorite shampoos for combating pyoderma. Next, disadvantage, these are corrosive to metal, so you are not supposed to wash the or clean the OT tables or anything, almirahs, anything which have a metal. Next disadvantage is inactivated by organic debris. Suppose you are cleaning the floor where there is blood droplets or some organ stainings, you need 2 to 3 washings for complete disinfection. Or first you have to clean with a brush or something to get rid of organic debris, then you have to use sodium hypochlorite. Next, iodine compound, iodophores. Iodophores is nothing but iodine plus detergent. Iodine compound plus detergent. Okay. Mostly it is available as scrub solution. They are basically used to clean the floors, and you may also find in comparison to alcohol, they have good antiseptic properties. So you will find povidone iodine scrubs in before going for operation. You have to wash your hands. Okay. So for that scrub solution, you may find iodophore compound. They have very good disinfectant properties, and the only disadvantage is staining. Okay, there will be brownish yellowish coloration, and also this is also inactivated by other nitrates. So the same principle for chlorinated compound applies to the iodine compound. These are three main types of disinfectant which is commonly used in OT room or in your surgery department premises. Now let us go for sterilization. This is very very important. So now coming to sterilization. Okay, we will see different techniques in different heads. First method, mechanism of action, temperature and time. This is very important because this comes as a short question. Okay, this whole sterilization comes as a long type questions. Then advantage and disadvantage. First of all, by heat. Okay, by heat. So you can use as a dry heat or moist heat. Dry heat is nothing but the instrument which is used, the equipment is hot air oven. Remember, this even is outdated, not being used in surgery. The mechanism of action by heat is coagulation or protein denaturation. Same for dry heat and moist heat. Only remember the temperature if a short question comes, 175 degrees Celsius for 3 hours. Okay, this is outdated, this is not used. Next, moist heat. Moist heat, the equipment used is autoclave. Okay, the mechanism of action is same, that is coagulation or protein denaturation. Next, you see there is four different things, four different temperatures and time periods. These two is for gravity type autoclave. Okay, you can give 132 to 135 degrees Celsius for 10 to 15 minutes, or this is most common, 121 degrees Celsius for 15 to 30 minutes. This one is for pre-vacuum type. Okay, 132 to 135 degrees Celsius for 3 to 5 minutes. You see the huge difference between time. Why? Let me show you why. You see, I am taking an example of vertical autoclave. Okay, this is a vertical autoclave. Here will be the heating coil. Okay, you have to fill the water up to the level of heating coil. There will be a stand, tripod stand. Okay, on which there will be a sterilization bin, that is rigid sterilization system. This bin is known as rigid sterilization system. Inside the bin you will be keeping your surgical pack. Remember, the surgical pack should be double wrapped. Okay, and here there will be a lid. On this lid there will be two whistles and 1 meter to measure the pressure. Okay, this is the construction of autoclave. Why two whistles? One is, you see there will be different levels, the orange, then green, then red. Okay, the one whistle, when there will be green, the indicator will be at green level. Okay, when it will hit the 15 psi pressure and the temperature, this whistle will blow. Okay, it will blow, then the temperature will come down, then again it will reach the required temperature, or it will maintain in that temperature. This one is a red whistle. Okay, this will be mostly green color, green whistle. This will be red whistle. Why red whistle? Suppose this green whistle is not working. Okay, what will happen? It may blast.
Okay, so the red whistle, when the indicator will touch the red mark, suppose there is a problem with the green whistle, it will blow up. Okay, so that is saving many lives. Okay, most advanced will have two whistles. Okay, and it will be kept on a stand. Okay, so this is a vertical type autoclave and this is a gravity type. Why? Let me remove this one so that I can understand, I can make you better understand the concept. You see, inside this is water, inside this is air. Okay, when the heating coil will heat, first the lower level air will get heated, then it will go up because they will become lighter, then the heavier air will come down, then again heat up. So this takes some time. Okay. Suppose I will develop a mechanism through which I can suck out all these airs. Okay, I can create a vacuum so that the water will be directly returned, the vapor will be created. There will be no time for this, the convention of air. Okay, that is why the pre vacuum time and difference between pre vacuum time and gravity type. This is gravity type. When there will be a mechanism for sucking out the air, that is pre vacuum time. That is why the time is less. Okay, even if same temperature, this is 10 to 15 minute gravity time, but in here it is 3 to 4 minute. You understand the gravity type and pre vacuum time? This is flash sterilization. For flash sterilization, what do you mean by flash sterilization? Suppose emergency case came. Okay, you have already done an operation and you have a dirty instrument, so you can sterilize in an emergency. Okay, that is known as flash. Okay, the temperature and time is 3 to 10 minutes. 3 minutes if you are using the if you have instruments that is non porous. If you are having some porous instruments, you can go for 10 minutes. Okay, so flash sterilization is nothing but a gravity type sterilization. Only thing is you perform it in emergency. And also another thing, in flash sterilization it should be single wrapped, because you are doing in an emergency. Okay, this one is single wrapped. Next, the advantages, this is most suitable for departmental activities, because most of the instruments are metal or stainless steel, and also you can use drapes, mops, you can sterilize the mops. Okay, but problem is there is some heat sensitive instrument, like instruments with lenses, that is laparoscopic tube. Okay, endoscopy tube. Okay, any rubber instruments. Okay, these cannot be sterilized in autoclave. Okay, for them we have chemical sterilization. We'll understand next. So now we'll go for the chemical sterilization. First one was the heat sterilization, now the chemical sterilization. Under these there are two types of sterilization: gas sterilization or cold sterilization. Gas sterilization is ethylene oxide sterilization. Cold sterilization we use glutaraldehyde. Okay, the ethylene oxide and glutaraldehyde, they are basically aldehydes. So aldehyde do alkylation. So the mechanism of action is alkylation of protein. So this same for glutaraldehyde. Now coming to temperature and time, 49 to 60 degree Celsius, 2.5 to 5 hours. There is an instrument. I will try to incorporate an image in this video. You can see the instrument. Okay, 2.5 to 5 hours. The thing is the aeration time. Okay, in both the chemical and also the gas, you need a aeration time. Okay, why this is needed? To remove the extra vapors. Okay, the aldehyde vapors. Extra vapors, they can be removed by, you see, if you are using a manual, that means you, after sterilization, keep it in open air. You need 7 days to remove all the residues. While in a mechanical aerator, okay, the machine is mechanical aerator, it requires 8 to 12 hours. This aeration time, okay, it's disadvantage of this ethylene oxide. Okay, lengthy cycle. You see, if I am taking the minimum side, 2.5, if I am using the manual, 7 days. Okay, even if I use the mechanical, it took 10 hours, 10.5 hours minimum. Okay, this is too much time. Next, the advantage is, you see, in autoclave you can't use heat sensitive or moisture sensitive equipment, but they can be sterilized in ethylene oxide or glutaraldehyde. This is not much of a use, but ethylene oxide sterilization, there is a specific machine for that. Okay, so you can use you can sterilize the heat or moisture sensitive instrument, like I told you, the instrument with lenses or rubber instruments. And this is the disadvantage: lengthy cycle, and this is also very very costly. And this is also important: it is a irritant to eye and mucous membrane. Sometimes if you inhale too much of vapor, it can cause CNS depression. Okay, you need to be very very careful when using the chemical sterilization. This is glutaraldehyde cold sterilization. The temperature is basically room temperature, 20 to 25 degrees Celsius for 10 hours. It also needs aeration. Okay, this is the chemical sterilization. Okay. Now, the plasma sterilization and ionization sterilization. First one is the plasma sterilization. Plasma sterilization, the mechanism actually is generation of free radical, mostly the generation of hydrogen peroxide gas. If you know chemistry, you know that hydrogen peroxide produces free radicals. Okay, next, temperature and time. The 50 degrees Celsius is temperature, time is 45 minutes. This is way safer than the ethylene oxide. Okay, this is also its advantage, and this is also suitable for heat sensitive equipments. Okay, but the only disadvantage is it is very very costly. Next is ionization radiation, that is ionization sterilization. Here we use cobalt 60, okay, gamma rays, production of gamma rays. This is not used in surgery department, but this is used in commercial grade. Like if you will see your sutures, different sutures or different gloves or surgical gloves, they will be gamma sterilized. Okay, so this is basically used in commercial grade industries. So the mechanism action, you know, any radiation is denaturation of DNA. So this is all about the disinfection and sterilization. The sterilization comes as a long question. Okay, you see, in examination you do not write to need do not need to write too much lengthy papers. Okay, you can make this tabular form in your exam paper, so that the teacher will understand what you need to say. It will save your time and also space. Okay, there are some old fashioned teachers also, they need to write, they need to see the lengthy and bulky writings. If you point out, if you find out these type of teachers, then you can go for lengthy one. But most of the teachers now in our generation also, in current situation also, they prefer the short and simple approach. Okay, so you can go for this tabular form. Thank you very much, and I am very much thankful to many of the my friends and colleagues and juniors for their support. So please like, share and subscribe. We'll meet in next class, which will be basically shock and fluid therapy, which is also another very 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 important topic. Thank you. Bye bye.